both Sotheby's and Christie's New York held their final magnificent jewel sale of the year. Let's take a look at the top lots from Sotheby's, as detailed by Gary Schuler.
We are very privileged to be able to offer a selection of jewelry from the collection of Mrs. Charles Wrightsman. One of my most favorite items in this upcoming sale is this exceptionally rare 21 millimeter natural gray pearl. It has been written up by the SSEF labs in Switzerland as being one of the most exceptional pearls ever to have come through their laboratory, estimated to sell in the $400,000 to $600,000 range. One of the featured items in that collection is a beautifully executed corsage ornament consisting of several very fine quality diamonds, two exceptional pear shapes, 8.5 to 9.5 carats of D color and E color. The center stone in the brooch is 9.5 carat cushion shaped diamond. This is estimated to sell in the $800,000 to $1.2 million range. One of the most interesting items in the Lauder collection is the 47.14 carat fancy intense heart-shaped diamond. It has a wonderful story that goes along with it. It was originally purchased by the Duchess of Windsor in approximately 1951 from Harry Winston. Several years later, the Duchess then privately sold the heart shape to Mrs. Estee Lauder, who then took the stone to Van Cleef & Arpels, who remounted it in its current form. This is estimated to sell in the $1.5 to $2 million range. The last lot in our afternoon session will be a 33.84 carat VVS2 D color cut cornered rectangular modified brilliant diamond, which is being offered by a prominent American family, estimated to sell in the $2.5 to $3 million range. Also included in the Lauder collection is the 22.16 carat emerald cut D potentially flawless diamond that was sold by the Graff Diamond Company. Again, a beautifully cut stone with excellent polish, excellent symmetry. It's one of those wonderful crystals that is just whiter than white. Estimated to sell in the $3 to $4 million range. Excellent. In the variance owners portion of our sale, we have a 52.73 carat square step cut fancy vivid yellow diamond, really of exceptional quality. This comes from a distinguished private collection here in the United States, estimated to sell in the $3 to $4 million range. One of the most anticipated items that will be offered in our upcoming sale is the 6.54 carat fancy intense pink diamond of internally flawless clarity. It's oval shaped. The estimate is $4 to $6 million. This is being sold for the benefit of the Breast Cancer Research Foundation. This is part of a larger collection that is being offered by the Lauder family in memory of Estee and Evelyn Lauder.
In the end, Sotheby's sale total of nearly $65 million set a new single-day record for its New York jewelry auction. The sale included $15.5 million from the Wrightsman Collection and $22.2 million from the Lauder Collection, which benefited the Breast Cancer Research Foundation. Now over to Rockefeller Center, where Raul Cadakia previewed the top lots for Christie's.
There's a three-stone Colombian emerald ring. All three are green emeralds, and it has a great effect because the colors enhance each other. You have an 8-carat center with 4 carats on each side, all fine, old Colombian muso material, priced at $500,000. There is a 30-carat vivid yellow, vivid being the strongest saturation in a colored diamond. And we have a 30 carat, a very important size, vivid yellow VS Clarity diamond ring that's going to make between $1.8 to $2.2 million. The sale also has a beautiful Art Deco sapphire and diamond bracelet by American jeweler Paul Flatow. Flatow was known mostly for making great jewels, great objects, whimsical jewels, using hands as a prop. So this, as an important bracelet with sapphires and diamonds, is a rare jewel to have in the auction, and we hope it'll fetch over $100,000. The sale also features a 3 carat 15, which is the largest size in its kind, for a reddish-orange diamond. Very rare stone, because it fuses two of the rarest colors in the diamond world, red and orange, and we expect the stone to make anywhere between $700,000 to $1 million. So the stone you see behind me is a 50 carat D color, the best, as colorless as can be, potentially flawless diamond ring by Graff. It's mounted in a ring by Graff, and we have it priced between $7 and $10 million.
Christie's sale totaled $32.5 million, and even with a few of those top gems unsold, it was still 84% sold by lot. Time now to check on how precious metals prices performed this past week. For all the latest industry news, be sure to check diamonds.net and follow us on Facebook and Twitter.